Next week is shaping up to be one of the most disruptive in decades as another union prepares and pushes ahead with industrial action. Nurses will stop work on Tuesday. Teachers from both the public and Catholic sectors will strike on Thursday. And now the rail union has announced a range of different actions that will throw regular timetables into chaos. Lachlan Kennedy joins me now live from State Parliament. Lachlan, what's going to be happening and why?
Sandra, a hurriedly organised meeting between the Transport Department and the Rail Union is starting right now to try and avert this action, but essentially negotiations have fallen through again. The Rail Union says it had been waiting on the state government to come back to it on a number of issues, including safety concerns about the new intercity fleet. But a meeting organised for 9 o'clock this morning with the Treasurer and the Employment Minister was cancelled at the last minute with no reason given. So the union is ramping up its protected industrial action starting on Tuesday, where trains in the metro area will go slow, no faster than 60 kilometres per hour, which will affect timetables. And then on Friday, the most disruptive action, the union is refusing to operate foreign-made trains, which means only 30% of the rail fleet will be on the tracks.
I want to be really honest and upfront with the people of New South Wales that this is not something that we want to do. It's not something that we want to do lightly, but it's as a result of the actions or the inaction of a couple of government ministers, I've got to say.
This escalating union action is far from the only headache for Dominic Perrottet. A senior, long-serving Liberal MP has publicly aired serious allegations about one of his colleagues, another Liberal MP, the Liberal Party and a property developer. Allegations so serious that the Premier today referred them to the corruption watchdog.
Under the protection of parliamentary privilege, the Liberal member for Castle Hill has aired serious accusations about his own party.
Allegations have been raised with me that senior people within the New South Wales Liberal Party, a member of the Liberal Party state executive and former Hills councillor, were supported financially at the time by a large developer by the name of Gene Nassif, who owns Top Place.
Ray Williams has claimed a plot was devised and executed to replace Liberals on Hills Shire Council.
Apparently, prior to the council elections, Gene Nassif of Top Place met with Christian Ellis and other senior members of the Liberal Party who were paid significant funds in order to arrange to put new councillors on the Hillshire Council who would be supportive of future Top Place development applications.
The applications, he alleged, involved this site on Castle Hill Road where Top Place has proposed apartment towers. Christian Ellis was formerly a member of the Liberal Party state executive.
If Christian Ellis and senior members of the Liberal Party, a former councillor and now member of the New South Wales Parliament, received financial benefit from Gene Nassif of Top Place, then my community have good reason to be very, very concerned.
Now I'd urge the member for Castle Hill to take his concerns to the Independent Commission Against Corruption.
10 News First has contacted Christian Ellis, Top Place and the current Liberal MP for comment. None have responded. The Premier says he immediately requested advice from his department, adding the advice stated that it would be appropriate to bring the matters raised to the attention of the ICAC, which I have now done, a position Party HQ says it supports.
These allegations bookend a budget week where the government has battled to sell its agenda. The controversy surrounding John Barilaro's trade posting to New York also proving a damaging distraction.
It's alleged the recruiter handling the role was told to stop looking a day before Mr. Barilaro quit Parliament. A public inquiry into his appointment starts on Wednesday. Lachlan Kennedy for 10 News First.